Good morning, children. Glad to meet you again today. Before we start our activities, let us start the day with a meditation with God's Word this morning, taken from Journey to God's Promised Land book, written by Pastor Marolap Sagala. Our topic for today is Miriam died and was buried. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Numbers chapter 20, verse 1. It says, "In the first month, the whole Israelite community arrived at the Desert of Zin, and they stayed at Kadesh. There Miriam died and was buried." The journey of the Israelites had been very tiring. It was caused by their attitude, which always grumbled and didn't fully believe in God. Among the Israelites who came out of Egypt, which was recorded as 20 years old, many have died along the journey. They died gradually. Some have died because of God's punishment, namely Korah, Dathan, and Abiram, died an unnatural death. The 250 who joined the rebellion with Korah, Dathan, and Abiram, they died being struck by the fire from God. Then about 14,000 more died of plagues due to God's punishment. Miriam died and was buried in the Desert of Zin. At the time, the entire nation of the Israel was living in Kadesh. Miriam's death was not a punishment from God. Indeed, God had punished her with leprosy, but Moses begged and prayed to God for her recovery. Of course, Moses has lost his sister Miriam. When Moses was still a baby, Miriam took care of him when his mother Jochebed hid him in the Nile River. Of course, Moses was not the only one who felt the loss of Miriam by her death. Aaron also certainly feels the loss, because Aaron, Miriam, and Moses were siblings of one mother. The Bible records the death of Miriam, although not much is said about Miriam's death in the Desert of Zin. Children, what is certain is that when someone dies during the journey, it means that they are not given the right to enter the land of Canaan, God's promised land. What we should yearn is so that we are eligible to enter God's promised land. So, let us remain faithful to God in our journey of life to God's promised land. This is the end of our morning worship. May the Lord bless all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.